Hey guys, welcome back, and if you're new to my channel, welcome. So I want to start off this video by giving credits to a cousin of mine, Pelon Barajas, and I want to give him the credit because he was actually the one that gave me the idea for this video. He didn't know he gave me the idea until I told him afterwards, but because of him, I got a topic and I really liked it. It's very, very interesting, and it's about selling your soul to the devil. So let's get into the video. Okay, so right before I start, I just want to go ahead and apologize for any names I butcher, especially the names of demons and of the people, because I don't want to get possessed. I don't want to fuck up these like demons' names and then for them to come for me like in the middle of the night. I pray to God that does not happen. I don't want to get scared. The first person I'm going to talk about is Urban Grandier. He was a French Catholic priest that was burned at the stake in 1634. He was accused of witchcraft. Unlike most of the victims of the witch hunts, there was a lot of evidence pointing to Urban and his connections with the Prince of Darkness. And he was also accused of bewitching a group of nuns and summoning the demon Asamadi to do evil acts with the nun. During his trials, the judges actually pulled out some documents that proved his pact with the devil, and it was even said that it had Satan's signature on it. And this is what the document said. We, the influential Lucifer, the young Satan, Belisalba, the Thebian, Elima, and Astroth, together with others, have today accepted the convent pact of Urban Grandier, who is ours. In him do we promise the love of women, the flower of virgins, the respect of monarchs, honor, lust, and power. He will go whoring 3 days long. The corsel will be dear to him. He offers us once in the year a seal of blood. Under the feet he will trample the holy things of the church, and he will ask us many questions. With this pact, he will live 20 years happy on the earth of men. And will later join us to sin against God. Okay, so the next person I'm going to talk about has to be one of the most well-known people that has been said to sell their soul to the devil for return for wealth, fame. I'm talking about the famous blues guitarist Robert Johnson. It is said that Robert went to a crossroad in Mississippi and sold his soul to the devil to be able to become the best blues guitarist in history. What makes this even more convincing is that the people that had known Robert before it was said that he sold his soul and after he sold his soul said that his playing changed so much that it was like two different people were playing, that you didn't believe it was him from before. And his death does not help this rumor at all, because he died of unknown causes. Robert did very little to deny that he sold his soul, and he actually wrote songs about it, like Me and the Devil Blues, The Crossroad, and Hellhound. So if you're not denying it and if you're doing very little to deny the fact that you sold your soul to become the best blues player in history, and you have songs about it, like this one.
Early this morning, when you knocked upon my door. Early this morning, ooh, when you knocked upon my door.
It pretty much says that you did sell your soul. Another weird fact about Robert is that he actually started the 27 Club, and that club is famous people that died at the age of 27 in random circumstances. Now, the very first and only woman on our list is Antoinette Rose. And it is said that she sold her soul to the devil back in the 15th century. And Rose was a person that was very, very poor. And she just could not take it anymore. I'm sorry, I spit on you. So she could not take it anymore. So she actually went to her neighbors to ask for help. And they took her to a group of people that convinced her to ask the devil for help. Now he appeared to her and agreed to help her overcome poverty under the condition that she would refuse God and worship him. So she accepted, and he gave her a foot and a half long stick in a small little pot of ointment. So he asked her to put some ointment on this, stick and stick it in her while she said the words, "Go in the name of the devil, go." In her confessions, she actually named some of the tributes that the worshippers did, like dancing and fasting and kissing the devil's hindquarters when he appeared in a physical form of a black dog. The fourth person I'm going to talk about is the famous painter Christoph Hansmann, and he sold his soul after his parents died. In exchange for relief of depression and poverty, he agreed to be the earthly son to the devil for 9 years. After these 9 years, he became so scared that he actually went looking for a priest and got an exorcism done. Now this did calm his nerves and made him feel a little bit better. But in 1678, he started feeling scared again and feeling like the devil was coming to collect. He got another exorcism done. And he started painting again after the exorcisms, and he actually painted his encounters with the devil and how he felt in his experience with them. So the last person I'm going to talk about is Jonathan Moulton, and he was a cabinet maker that later on became a captain in the New Hampshire militia. The war ended in 1749 and he got married. Now, the couple struggled a lot, and he promised his wife that he was gonna sell his soul so they can have the wealth that he wanted. The neighbors would say that they saw a stranger visit the couple once a month, and it's said that the devil will fill Jonathan's boot with gold coins on the first of every month. And the couple suddenly became rich. So Jonathan was very greedy, and it was just not enough for him. So one day he decided to trick the devil. So he bought bigger shoes. And once again, once a month, on the first of the month, the devil came and filled his boots. But that still was not enough. So what he did next was make a hole on the sole of the shoe and make a hole on the ground. Now, it worked one time. And the first of the month came once again. And then the devil realized that there was a hole on the floor and that Jonathan was trying to outsmart him. So he burned down their house. Later on, Jonathan actually rebuilt the house in the exact same spot, and that house is still standing till today. I really hope you guys liked the video. Please go ahead and give it a huge thumbs up, comment, subscribe, and turn on your notification bell so you know when I post next. It helps me out a lot. And next time you need something, just do it the old-fashioned way, because later on, the hellhounds will be coming for you.